What's up, everybody? Hope you're doing good today. So right there, there's this like secret path. Check this out. So cool. These guys' explosions can open up secret walls. Also, these guys. I think there's another secret wall here, too. Yes, so cool. So, loving that. That's awesome. Today I'm going to be working on this goal room chamber thing, though. So, let me get to that goal chamber. I think it was 264. Yeah, here it is. This is the goal chamber thingy. When you get to, once you beat the boss, you come into this goal room. And I'm trying to make a really special type thing happen here with the goal room. What happened to the floor is not supposed to be black right there and there. Let's check that out. Where was that code again? Create ground tile. I don't know right now. So one of the first things I want to do is I want to make it like way more epic. So I want a light beam shooting out of the top of it. I want it to like crack open and then a light beam appear and then like smoke. So let's start with the light beam. The gold container could do a light beam. Where would I do that at? Probably the easiest place to start that. I'd have to do a bunch of animations. I guess I could do open a goal container. So should I do a pixel art? No, I think I was thinking of just a plane, like a single plane of light. So it can kind of like expand. What's up, Rocket? You've been expecting. How you been, man? I guess we could do something like this. Animate. What's up, Speedy Flip? How's it going, man? You've had the tab open? I'm good, man. Gosh, this is a crazy... This is such a crazy thing right here. Anime, light, beam, gold, container. Let's just call this gold container. Okay, so there. The gold container triggers this. And then in AI system... We want to look for that. You ate too much candy? Oh no! Oh, I did put dashes between a lot of these. Okay. So if Sterval 0 equals gold container light beam thing. Here's where we're going to animate this gold container thing. What's up, Salad? Salad Dogs is here. Okay, so we're going to start with a plane. A white colored plane that just appears and goes and then just goes across the screen and fades out really quick. So we want to do a new layer color. Parent node is the entity that's running is. Actually, the gold container thing should go in this middle of the screen. So it should be on the game scene layer. Oops. And its color, it's a 4B. White. Fully opaque. We've got float Z or width. Okay, I want it to be the whole screen size. And Z, like really high. All right, so if the light, start the light off at like, I want it to be about a pixel wide. So it's gonna be 1 over the frame buffer size dot width. And we'll call that scale X. Whoops. What the hell? Oh. All right, so layer color, what did I do? These right. Parent color, width, height, pause, Z. What the hell? Oh, Vim's. What's up, Vim? What are you doing, Vim? Okay, so we're going to run an action. So duration, what do we want for duration? Oh, Salad, I have not yet. I've still been like just working so much. What have you caught, man? Well, so what did you end up catching, man? What did you see? What games? Oh, yeah. Do I know any places you could hire an artist? What's that one, Elance? It became something else, though. It's not called Elance anymore, but it's called Odesk, maybe? Or Upwork, there it is. Yeah, Upwork. Maybe. I don't know. Might be a place you could find an artist. I think it, I think the white line or whatever. First of all, we need to fade though. Okay, so we'll make goal container also. Float val 1, float val 0. That's the duration. Okay, so back to the goal container. When it calls this anime goal container, it can do its duration right here. Oh, standouts. Taz block. What's Taz block? Super Metroid, yes. Oh, interesting. The awful games block? What? Tell me about the awful games block. What's that? Hey, Wolf Quest. Oh, Taz block. Oh, there's a Taz block? Really? That sounds fun. Wolf Quest. I gotta check this out. I'll check this out. Bear Simulator, yeah. Okay, so wait, the goal container was at the wrong. It didn't need a position. Just pause 0. Really? Oh, there it went. Nice. I saw it. What's up, Dom Killer? Is there 2017 out yet? Lots of them. Sweet, I'll check these out. Awesome. Okay, so what I'm in the middle of right here is making this goal container thing. So you fought the boss, you beat the boss, you go into the next room, and that's what this room is. And I'm working on making this cooler. Nice rocket. What's up, Loco Boy? Okay, so I'm trying to do a light thing, animation. Oh, so actually, if I make the width 0, and the height 1, then it'll start in the middle of the screen. Oh, and also it should be at the Z of the middle of the screen. So we'll make a const float Z equals render component. Dead Z order K Z mid for pause. Tazbot. What's up, Pithlix? How's it going? So this gets the order function. What is it again? Oh, offset. Okay, so it's layer, offset, pause. Okay, so I wanted to scale to, it scales over the X, it gets really big and then fades out. That's what I wanted to do. You're watching on the PS4? Cool. Right on. I need to get myself a PS4. It's like dying really quick. Oh, wait a minute. I'm not even destroying the layer. What the? Yeah. Okay, so this function here, even though I'm not even like anywhere close to having it right, I should put it in the right place. It should be in a nims. So the goal container just has a duration. Everything else is taken care of. So let's go to a nims. Void goal container. I guess all it has is a duration. Okay, so copying that code back from AI system. This stuff here. How big is Songbringer? What do you mean big? How big what? The game when you play it? The time you spend playing it? The lines of code written it? What you mean? What you mean, man? There we go. Okay, so now we got a little self-contained goal container thingy. That's all that matters. How long it takes to finish it? Probably about 8 hours, I'd imagine, is an average time. Size is better than quality. It's probably about an 8 hour game. And if you're fast, you can get it done in like 2 or 3 hours. If you're speed running, you can get it done like faster. Right now, like an hour and a half for sure. Maybe in the future, I'm sure some people are gonna be doing it wicked fast, like at half an hour, 45 minutes. Cause you can skip a lot of, there's a lot of the game you can skip if you know the right secret paths. There's so many secret paths. So you could like literally just sneak into the last dungeon if there were secret paths, even without any items. Well, there's a few dungeons you'd have to do. There's like, yeah, there's a couple of them you'd definitely have to do to like trigger all the story elements and stuff like that. But You can even play the game in reverse boss order and all that. I want this game to be really, really flexible and never for it to like tell you what to do. I hate that about video games where they tell you what to do. I love video games that just leave you and let you do whatever you want. Like the original Zelda. Why has there not ever been a game like that since then? It seems like. Why does every other game have to like hold your hand at first? That's like the whole concept of Songbringer is to make a game that doesn't hold your freaking hand. It's like, let me cross the street myself. I'm 6 years old already. You know? Okay, so let's see this animation way slower. I want the light beam to shoot out of the thing and then to go pfft, and then do a sound effect and some smoke and stuff. Okay, so we need that motion to be better, so that was back in gold container. Oh, let's make this longer. 9 seconds, maybe. A Link to the Past, yeah. Yeah, A Link to the Past was really, really good too. But the thing about Link to the Past is it does hold your hand. It forces you through that first dungeon, you know? You have to go play the first dungeon. In the first Zelda, you don't have to even go play the first dungeon. I love that. I love you can just walk into the third dungeon or whatever. Oh, Link Between Worlds? I don't know. I haven't tried it either. Which one was Link Between Worlds? Was that the redo? The remake of Link to the Past? Is that one? You never beat the original Oh, it is such a feeling of accomplishment to beat the first Zelda. It's like, yeah. And there's people that can do it so fast. There's speedrunners out there that can do that in under 30. I think it's under 30 minutes now. It's definitely sub 35 minutes. Yeah, so which one is this? Why am I looking at Wikipedia? Oh, it is the redo. Oh, so I never played this one. I would imagine, okay, so I don't know, I haven't played this, but somebody tell me, does this hold your hand more than the original Link to the Past? Or does it let you roam freer? Or is it just the same? It looks really good. But I like the original art too. It's the top of your list. Same with Metroid? Yeah, Metroid 2. Metroid's another one where like you beat it and you feel like you just accomplished so much. Another one that was huge for me personally beating was Solstice. The original Solstice. Finding your way through that maze. Oh my god. That's such a crazy game to beat. Oh, it kind of sets you loose? That's cool. Yeah, me too, man. Oh, have you guys ever seen this? Where it shows what Zelda actually looks like from the side. They actually did this for A Link Between Worlds. They have these 3D models, but everything's all tilted over, so it looks like the original game. It's crazy. Okay, back to this light thing. Why is this animation not even anywhere near, right? Okay, at least I got it in the right place. Yes. What do we think about the Switch? Oh, speedrunners say, oh, it's a sequel? Really? Hmm. Nobody beats Solstice. Dude, there's a guy online that can beat it in like under 10 minutes. It's crazy. Why a new keyboard would shut down someone's computer? Hmm. The most you can do with Solstice is get it to grant you mercy. Right? It's so hard. The Souls games, I've only played the intro to the first Dark Souls. Past the intro. I played to like the first boss or something and then just got my ass kicked so hard. And I just I'm not really a 3D games kind of person these days. I'll play a 3D game on a console system, but I just don't like having to sit at my computer and play a game. I prefer to kick back on my couch. And so that's why I like to, I guess I could play them. I don't know. There's something about 3D games. I prefer the 2D game perspective and the 2D game play. Just the gameplay of 2D games, I like it better for some reason. I like the simplicity of it, like not having to worry about the third dimension and the kind of the nostalgic feeling or whatever of playing games in two dimensions. I like that. Okay, so this thing's just disappearing on us. Where is it going? Whoops. Almost did that right. Control V. Okay, so instead of these scales and moves, let's just do a delay time. So if you're just tuning in, what I'm working on here is this goal room chamber thingy. It's like a chest almost. You beat the boss, you go inside the goal room. And then this stuff happens to, so it seems cooler. It seems more rewarding to get an item that's inside some kind of chambery thing like this. So I'm trying to work on making like a light beam effect that comes up from it, and so a better sound effect and some smoke. I think that'll really help this just pop. Oh, misc tile. I know what's wrong with that one bit of thing. Oh, no, what's wrong? Yes, yeah, rocket the chat. I haven't been able to fix the chat. It's so messed up. The chat window. What am I supposed to do about the freaking chat window? I can't freaking fix the chat window right now in game show. It's all messed up. There we go. Okay, now it's got a nice little checker mark right there. Okay, so the light beam is just disappearing like instantly. Why is that? Even though I set a duration before it removed itself. Just return from this method. Okay, it's not disappearing. That's great. Okay, I want it to be in the middle of the screen. It's not just stretched. Oh, now it's off the screen too. chat, dude. It changes like every time. Oh man. I'm just gonna laugh. I'm just gonna laugh for a while and leave it. Oh, okay, I missed it. But the white area, though, it looks like I got the white area closer to where it's supposed to be. Maybe I'll take the Eid so I can get its position of the entity that calls this. Jeez, man, going back never gets me where I want to go. I'm in a loop. I'm stuck in a loop. Soon, yeah, soon we won't even see it. It'll scooch itself off the side of the screen. Won't even be there anymore. No more chat window. It's gone forever. Can't ever come back. You try and create another one and it just dies right away. It's lonely. Okay, so the Enim's goal container. Where did I do that again? Oh, AI system. AI system.cpp. Passing in e.id. Go forward. Come on, go forward didn't even work. Give me, oh, let's go back. That's right. All right, so Eid, we'll take the position of the entity. Yeah. I'll have to go back to just having the chat. You know, maybe I should. That's one way to do it, Rocket. I could go back old school. That's the ticket, Rocket. We're doing it right now. Maybe I can turn this thing off in the middle. Hopefully this doesn't kill the stream. Delete the chat window. Screw this thing, man. How do you delete it? It's not gone yet. It's gone. Is it gone? Da da da. Da 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 da. It won't die. It's still there. No! Oh, there it's gone. It's gone. Yes. Thought I was gonna be like a zombie for a minute. Here we go. Yeah. So I got this new little shortcut. I press GJ to go backwards in Vim. And I always think, good job, good job. Whenever I type GJ, I'm like, good job, good job, good job. Sometimes I do it and I don't even need to do it. I'm like, oh, I just want to type GJ and say good job in my head. First, yeah, you're first, man. Woo! I got two chat windows now. I got one chat window underneath my code, and I got another chat window just to the left. It's like the stream started again. You're definitely first, man. Had to have been the scale. Because all I commented out was the scale X, and now there's this light. Bam! There we go. That's kind of what I want. All right. This big old light, that's what it'll look like eventually, once it's all spread out. So now we need to get it to set the scale really small. And then scale it out. It's not fully like it used to be. You're right. It's not. It's just not. It never will be. The past is the past. We've got to let go of it as fast as we can. I know, I actually had to click on the chat. It's not the same. But I do have to click on the chat sometimes, right? Look at this. Look how much I'm clicking on the chat right now. This is so chat clicky. Hey, wait, I'll turn off my Twitch thing here, or my iPad. There, now it's totally like the old school days. Right on. Rockin', man, yeah. All I need is Vim. I don't need no stupid Xcode. Maybe I'll close Xcode right now. Yeah, this will be the first day I've closed Xcode and just worked entirely in Vim. Stop clicking on us. I'm clicking on you. Oh, I can actually open links in Safari. That's pretty cool, right? Use Chrome. You don't want me to use Chrome? That's funny because Boogie the other day was like, you got to start using Chrome again. And I did actually start using Chrome again because Safari got all messed up. He is a rebel. Okay, so if I set it to a scale, X of 1 over the... That's 1 420th or whatever. Using a GUI. What GUI? Which GUI? Oh, Xcode? Using an OS on an Emacs? So what's wrong with this thing here? When I turn back on this scale thing. Oh, maybe we'll do this. I'll make it like 90%. There. 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 It's Sunday. Happy Sunday. It's probably Monday for some of y'all. What the hell? It just disappears. Hold on, wait. What if I do the scale? I think I did this before. Let's do this 2 over, so that'll become... Yeah, 2 pixels wide. So all it's doing is delaying and then running. You must be looking in a mirror. Nice. Nice. How old's your brother? What's up, Space My Name? It disappears. Why does it disappear? This is driving me crazy. If I set the scale X, it just disappears. Hold on a minute. What if I said a bigger? Why do you disappear on me? If I don't set scale X, it's fine. So weird. He's 11? And you gotta let it's 12? And Inception says 26? Whoa! You guys have a big family. Okay, light beam. What's your problem, man? So if I make it really big, it just works. It's visible. And then as soon as I set it to a small scale, it disappears right away. It's driving me crazy. Oh, it disappeared that time. Does it have a really low duration? Oh, it's 9.0. Wait. I do need Xcode. Damn it. I need Xcode. The snow hasn't even melted yet. Cool. Explode, rumble, NIMS. I want goal. Container. Okay. Maybe it's the float val 0. I never checked it. Wow. Float Val 0, what art thou? Oh, it's Float Val 1! The whole time it was that. I don't need Xcode anymore. See you, Xcode. Later. Okay, so let's set the scale and do the scaly thing. It's just sugar. It's the sugar, dude. What have you been drinking? What have you been eating? You just eating pure sugar? Just scoops of sugar. Granules of sugar. There we go. Something like this, but not lasting 9 seconds long. And a fade out. Yes, it's working finally. It was the freaking... It was definitely that. Forgot to set the most important variable. Okay, so let's start with 1. Maybe 2. So it scales 2 and fades out. And the overall duration should be way faster. You drink pure cane sugar and then a Red Bull? Oh, man. Nice, something like that. What is that? You don't actually drink sugar in Red Bull? I figured. So I want the goal container animation to happen before it starts. Like, or actually I wanted to go boom. Everything goes for like 1 pixel. I could just start the anime goal container. Up here. And we need a delay then. So the delay, let's put it also 1.8 maybe. And I want this to be way quicker, so like maybe 1 second. No Mars bars? We don't have Mars bars? We got Mars bars. You're not looking in the right places. We definitely have Mars bars. I've seen a Mars bar here before. How long ago, man? I guess you know what, Rocket? To be honest with you, I don't think I've had a Mars bar or even any candy at all. I'm not really much of a candy eater. I've never like gone to the store and bought candy in probably 20 years, man. So long ago. We do have Subway. Subway's pretty decent, right? In a pinch, Subway will do. All right, so we need to set this to be invisible as well. So L dot set visible. False. And then here we'll have a show. So delay, show, scale, fade, remove. All right, you're making me hungry. And I already had dinner. What do I get? Expected unqualified ID and NIMS. What am I doing? Oh, I put a semicolon at the end of this. You see that? What? Get hungry for a few days. Oh, if you eat that, you don't get hungry for what? Hear a sound this time. I gotta start working on this sound effect. Good job, good job, good job. Good job, good job, good job. It never takes you where I want to go. The good job doesn't work. Oh, there it is. Yeah. Nibs goal container. We need to delay a little longer. 2.0 maybe. This thing needs to go way faster. 0.2 maybe. That was way too fast. Takes very little to sustain me. So this should be a spawn. Good job, good job, good job. It doesn't take me where I want to go when I type good job. I don't know why. Gotta work on that. There you go, right? You want to buy much ramen at all? Two packs will last you a whole semester. Okay, also this should ease. Definitely is like a more powerful sound effect too. The sound effect is kind of weak right now. That was way cooler. So we'll do x0 equals 2.0 over FB size dot width. Starts off at 2 pixels. And goes to approximately 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks. Okay, so it starts off with scale x0 and goes to scale x1. Yeah, day house? He has a day house? Let me see his day house. Hamilton! What's up, Hamilton? How you doing, Hamilton? What's going on in there, man? Oh, it still got too big, what? What? Right, I love that name. Oh, it's this times that over FB size dot width. So we'll make the fade to be a sine out. This blue popcorn. The popcorn's blue now? What hamster would want to eat blue popcorn? Huh? Tell me that. You need some regular yellow colored popcorn so your hamster wants to eat it. It needs some good salt on it. Maybe a tiny bit of pepper. Or some like hot peppery flakes, or maybe like a little bit of like roasted caramel. You know, it depends on what Hamilton likes. What does Hamilton like? Does he like the salty or does he like the sweet kind of popcorn? What's his favorite kind of popcorn? Have you asked him this yet? This is important stuff, Rocket Bunny. This is very important. Bum, bum, bum. You don't know. You don't know. Ooh, nice. It didn't go far enough. It's the delay is the delay. That's the problem. The good job. Good job worked. This needs to be like half, and then the fade out takes the whole time. And then this needs to be like twice as long. He doesn't answer you. He just looks at you with the what the fuck look. He's like, what? Doesn't answer. Okay, wait. So let's get all science-y about this. You put one piece of blue popcorn in front of him and one piece of yellow popcorn in front of him. Right? Which one does he want? Which one does he want? That looked pretty cool, actually. See that again. This light's starting to look cool. It's starting to look cool for sure. We need some smoke still. Sound effect really needs some love there. It's not very good yet. But what do we do the two types of bedding? He started segregating them, really? What? See, he has a preference. He definitely likes one or the other for sure. Right? You know what I think it might need the additive blend funk. Wow, that was it? Nice, it looked great. Okay, so this should be like 50 or 40%. Let's go 50. Okay, I wanted to do that though before it. He just stares at you. What's up, novice? Yeah, I know it's pretty dark, right? It was a late stream today. Really? I gotta get some more water. I'm already back. All right, cool. We got a nice like light beam thing going on, but now I want some dust or maybe a sound effect. Should I start working? Yeah, let's start working on this. Oh man, working on the sound effect would be sweet, wouldn't it? That'd be the most impactful thing I could do right now. Sound effect time. Jump to the screen. How's the game coming along? Thank you, professional novice. The game's coming really well. Getting into the final phases of it right now. This week I did some significant stuff, actually. I did something like, let's see, to start my week off, I had 103 things on my Trello list, and now on my important list. Now I'm down to 24. So not this week, the last 2 weeks. So it's like 80 bugs I've fixed in the last 2 weeks. And made so much progress with like so many things. Like the update that I'm gonna release tonight will have more things on the change log list than I've ever done before. So it's gonna be crazy. And the next updates I'm gonna be doing are really exciting. So the next updates I'll be focusing on refining the bosses, finishing all the songs for the game, adding cutscenes. And adding in different puzzle patterns and like backtracking patterns too, where you can use like your advanced items to go get secrets and stuff like that back in previous dungeons. So there's gonna be a lot of cool, exciting stuff to be working on in the next few months. Yeah, you're in the home stretch of your project too. What's your project you're working on again? Pardon me for I can't remember. Do we still have audio? La 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 la. We still have audio. Yay. We still have game audio. Oh, the car diagnostic app, right. Oh, sweet. You're almost done with that? Dude, nice. I bet that's gonna be bank. You can probably sell it for an expensive price, right? Wait, so does the game still have audio? It's taking so long. If I click on this a bunch, it'll like go faster. Whoa, check this out. You can like throw in copies of it all. I didn't know you could do that. Wow. Yeah, we got game audio. Nice. All right, okay. So I've just successfully opened up X, or I mean, Ableton, and everything didn't crash. Everything is still fine. What? GM charges 50K a year? Holy crap. Wow, dude. You got a market there. This sounds awesome. I could check us in. anime goal container. There's the goal container animation, goal container. This is a start to this. Okay, so let's start off this sound effect and make it awesome. Yes! I think I... Oh, yeah, I started it already. It's called Goal Container. Yeah. Right? Or a big data company or something like that. So what do I got here so far? Okay, I don't like this. What is this one? This one's cool. This one's not. I don't like the middle. This thing. I don't like this track. Turn off this track. Okay, so the light beam coming down. I'm thinking like a, so it's like a B, like a, either a square wave or a triangle wave. Yeah. Right. Square. I think a square wave is where we want to go with this. Yeah, right on. Yeah, this I'm beeping over here. Okay, so it's gonna start off like. I guess I want a massive instrument, not one of these. I can't do this. Drop a massive in here. DT770s? What's that? Yeah, right on, Salad. Okay, new sound. Kill the vibrato. Well, we can keep some vibrato on this. Square. Smooth square. Low. do a low pass. So we'll start off about there and do its volume envelope going down to there. That doesn't sound right. Okay, it needs to last longer, like really long, probably this whole time. Oh, the headphones? No, these are Sennheisers. They're the HD25s, Sennheisers. I like them. They're so ripped and old though. Like the top's all ripped. The side thingies are all like these little foamy things are just supposed to go on your ears. Long ago, lost their top bit of leather, whatever it was. And I just super glued these little things that were on the inside back onto the back of it so they never fall off. These are so, but they were $250 headphones when I first got them. They're really great. They have a really nice low end response and everything. So they're the, kind of like the best $250 range like headphones I could get that would allow me to somewhat feel a little bit of bass. You know, this is like, you gotta use some studio monitors to check out your bass, but this kind of gives you a feeling for what the bass might be like. You get this morph thing. Okay, and besides, I want this to, this light beam noise to happen first, and then this low noise. So it'll go like, pew, boom. Bam, boom. So this is it right here. That's like a 1.5 seconds about. Septa! Hey, what's up, Septa? What's up, man? Hey, guys. Nice one, Rocket. Okay, so let's get back to this. Let's see the visuals one more time. So I can remind myself what I'm trying to do here. I'm trying to make a sound effect that sounds like a laser beam. Just a beam of light going, and then, and then the stones move. Rusty? No, I have not heard of this. Thank you. So it needs to start at like a higher pitch. And then go to a lower pitch. How do I get it to go down again? Oh, maybe it's this attack envelope. Go down, go down. I could glide two notes together. It's like one of those things, potato shreds, oh, fries. Oh, it's like a crepe. Cool. Yeah, Zepta, I use Massive a lot and Ableton. I'm using Ableton to write music mostly, and then Massive, I do like a lot of the sound effects or specific instruments for the sound effects. Okay. Why didn't that work? The pitch bend. It must have been that the envelope had too much attack or decay or release. Okay, I kind of get it now. I need to use a different envelope. There we go. Ah! You laugh too hard. Maybe this should be a pulse wave. There we go. Now it's getting more of that grainy, wizardy, warpy, waspy. Nice, there we go. You can make a lot of crazy noises with this. It's infinite. It's totally infinite what you can make with just mixing together three oscillators, some modulation, some noise, feedback, some inserts, filters. Man, you could do so much. Kind of cool both ways. I like both of these. You don't speak of the music? Man, you got to start speaking the music. You want to be a game developer, right? Make music. Start making music right now. Right now. You don't need software. I love that face. It's so cool. And if I add a little phaser onto this too... Might be double the phase. Phase mono, though. Nah, it didn't work. Chorus mono, maybe? Yes, yes! It costs so much! What are you talking about? It costs so much! What the heck are you talking about? Making music is so inexpensive. You need a bucket and two sticks. And your voice. You don't need instruments. Who told you that? Who told you you need instruments? You can make instruments, man. The bucket technique, yes. Yes, that's all you need to start making music, man. That's all you need. You don't need software. And there's even if you wanted to start with software, there's free software to make music. Trackers, exactly. I think it needs a little bit of dimension. Tiny bit. Tiny size. Okay, let's see how that sounds. Is this sounding right? Is this sounding wrong? How is this sounding? Okay, call this goal container. Just goal container? Yeah, goal container. That's it. You like the high pass? I like the high pass too, but I decided to go with that second oscillator because I wanted a specific higher noise, and I like that whatever this is. Because check us out, this is gonna be kind of like a triumphant scene here. Trackers. Deflamask. I haven't heard of that one. Yeah, I do usually stop for dinner. I already had dinner though, but I gotta have second dinner. I only had first dinner so far. The first time you could catch it? What's that? Oh, first time you catch a stream? Because it's later? Oh, that was almost right! Yeah, that was almost right. Sweet, that sounded good. Oh, let's see that again. It was almost the right timing. Elevensies, yeah. Midnight snack. 4 a.m. waking up for a moment snack. You know. I like Elevensies. Elevensies is my favorite. Okay, so let's work on this timing now. Right? What's my sleep schedule like? I like get to bed around 2 a.m. and I wake up around 10 a.m., sometimes 11 a.m. I work all day, 10 to 12 hours a day. I work 7 days a week. On Saturdays and Sundays, I typically get a few more hours of leisure time. But this is kind of crunch time for Songbringer. This is the last, you know, the last stretch. So I've got to be focused and I've got to get a lot done in the next, all of the next updates. This is the crunch time for Songbringer right here. You've never woken up past 9? Ever? Man, I highly recommend trying it. I have to compile. Yeah, I have to compile everything. So I want to do a little more delay here. So this is the delay, and this delays 2 and then does the initial thing. We want to do a little more delay on all these goal containers. So they got 1, 2, 3. Boom, boom, boom. Oh, wait, so we got to put this sound. Wait, the sound open doesn't happen until the timer's done. How is this even right? Wait, so is there silence at first? I'm kind of confused now. You're not a true teenager yet. Okay, cool. I just want to see this sound happen. And then wait a second before it starts its move. Oh, I got it. So wait. Do a sequence here. Initial three. Okay, so if we have a target this time, if target any, and if dir none, then we could do this a little bit. But here, this initial 2, we do the sound effect. So we animate. Delay, do the sound open, set another timer. This is like a timer should be 1 here. And this Is delays 3 or timer 3? This is if timer is less than 0. Or actually, we can just do a delay now. Delay 1. Okay, I gotta see where I'm at now. Yeah, Zixby! Yeah, there we go. I just want to see that delay happen right there. Nice. Did that sound happen at the right time, too? I can't tell. It delayed 1 second after it started playing sound open. So that was... It goes da-boom. Oh, it's a little over 1 second. What is this? 1.125 seconds. That'll sound a little bit better. 1.125. Timing just be perfect that way. Yeah, yeah. I'm definitely going to do that. I have a whole list of YouTubers I'm going to be reaching out to. It's like it started too late that time. Maybe this needs to be 0.9. Not bad, not bad. I think it maybe needs to be a little louder though. Thanks, Zixby. I don't though. I do all my own music. Thanks though. Good luck finding work, man. What have you been working on? What kind of projects are you working on right now? Needs to be a little bit louder. What is the volume coming out here? Is it so loud? No. What happened here? What? Oh. What happened? Oh, now it's working. That was weird. Nice, man, nice. Okay, so what is this sound at? -7. This could come up a little bit louder. I think on the whole master, let's do a compressor. Nah, that's a bad idea. Bad idea. No, we're gonna do a compressor on each individual track for sure. For certainty. Compress. Okay, so lower the threshold there. Rampier, a little bit of knee, a little bit of attack. That's better. Okay, and then what's the volume coming to now? -7 only? Oh, -5.8. Okay, that's pretty good. It's about -6. And we probably want to do the same kind of thing on this low. Some kind of compressor, but we'll start with that. So I already got a compressor. Never mind. Boom. How come I can't see you? This one's got... Oh, there it is. Like, where's your spectrum, man? it's pretty good. Gold container, a place. Okay, so it's got a nice delay now. That's really helping. And the sound effect also really helping. It'd be cool if there was a little bit of smoke from the things, the stones or whatever, moving. I wonder, okay, I'm gonna work on the timing a little bit more. Might need a tenth of a second here or there. Wait, 0.125. That's supposed to be 0.9. I think it needs a little bit more time here in the overall effect, maybe even more. Can't tell if they moved too soon or too late. What's up, Zilton? How's it going, man? Okay, so when I don't know whether it's too soon or too late, I try and go the what I think is the wrong way first. Kind of helps me. It's like tuning a guitar for me. I like to go past the point of the tune where I'm like, oh, now it's definitely out of tune. Okay, so that was too... That's what? It's like it didn't even change. Not much going on there, you talking about? Okay, it definitely did move too soon that time. Oh, they might have a... Oh, I see. Wait. They have this, their move component has zero acceleration. So if I add a little bit of acceleration, like it takes it 1 second or something to get started. And then let's do this later, like the whole 1 second. Okay, so that delay is way too long. That's pretty good. Yeah, it's pretty good. I like it. Why is it still shaking though? Is it ever gonna end? Wow, that would ship forever. Oh, because I shut the screen shake so long. 19? Why did I do that? Maybe 9. I think it was the goal container I wanted to be a lot longer. But now it's like perfect timing, almost. My own sound effects code library? No. I'm using a sound library called fmod, and it allows me to do lots of cool stuff. Like fmod has these has projects, so you can create these projects and do panning for your songs and everything. I've got all my songs set up so that they're procedural. So here's like the boss tune, for example, and it's different every time you play it because for every dungeon, I mean, there's a different keys, so that I've got a note 1, note 2, note 3, note 4. All the notes depend on the key of the dungeon, so the random numbers that get put into the dungeon are used to generate notes that all fit in the same key so that I can do procedural melodies. So this is it with a note 3, 1, 0, and 10. That's like a C, B, you know, whatever. And then there's other factors too, like an index. I can give this index parameter, so as you move through the dungeon, the index increases. The intensity gets stronger, so there's more. The more foes there are, there's like the intensity's up real high, and then as you kill more foes, the intensity goes down. So I can trigger different sound effects that way. Fmod's pretty neat. This is Fmod Studio. There's two components to Fmod. There's the Fmod Studio where you write your songs and stuff like this. And there's the Fmod low level thing where you use that in your game's code. And when you're looking at here, this is my custom scripting language for this game. This is my behavior trees. Okay, so I like the way that sounds and is and everything. I'm just going to save this and check this in so far. Goal container, sound, acceleration, timing. It's so good. That's such a nice little edit there. Yeah, it's a pretty great library. I like it. Okay, the last thing I want to do is add a little bit of smoke coming out of the goal container thingies. So I've got an animation for smoke somewhere. I think it's got to be here in this file too. Oh, it's not that smoke. Where is the smoke that I'm thinking of? What's this one? Add light beam? No, not light beam. Not rift. It's none of these. I call it in phase statue falls. I think it does this effect where the thing falls over, it rumbles the controller. Oh, here they are. Her name is Dust. Okay, so I'm gonna need to do a bunch of dust for each one of the big blocks that's moving. So that means that I should probably do, if I did an animation on the goal container, let me just copy this. Good job. Let's see what it looks like with just some dust appearing out of nowhere. I didn't see any dust that time. Okay, so dust takes a position, a count, and a duration. Position, count, duration. Okay. Let's make it negative. Well, okay, so I think this is giving us the position. Wait a minute, how did this even work? He's pissed off. Why? Did you make Hamilton go back in his cage? He's like, I don't want to go back in my cage. It's not nice of you, Rocket. Oh, leaving me out here in the cold. Putting me in my cage. Yeah. You just picked him up and now he's pissed. All right, so a little bit of dust, and that's going to be it. That's all I got for today's stream. Just some more dust. This is cool, though. It has this nice little animation going on when you pick up a goal item. Oh, it was one. Where's this dust at? Oh, it's at zero, that's why. Right, what's with that? Of course you did. Nice day, house. There we go. Now we got some dust. Finally. Okay, how about I'll just do a little bit of dust for the bottom and then a little bit of dust on the top of it. Oh no. No, Hammy. Hammington. He's everybody's favorite pet hamster. Weird. Some of them appear low and some of them appear high. Why is that? Okay, it's pretty much putting these at the same point that I give it, so. You must be calling this twice. Or four times. I need Xcode again. Gotta open Xcode. What the hell? Xcode forgot all of my projects. What? Making me. And then. My Mac OS keeps on forgetting all my favorite folders too. It like loses them all. Okay, this is getting called once for EID 303. And then for 304. And then 334. 335. They're all calling it. What? That explains a lot. Oh, because they're all doing it. Okay, so I just want one of them to do this gold container. No wonder the gold container animation was so bright. Same thing with the sound. It's because I did this here. Whoops. I just launched two Xcode compiles at once. What is happening? Are they actually both going? They did. They both compiled. That's crazy. That was enough dust. That was a good amount of dust right there. I liked it. I liked it a lot. Oh, what Z order does the dust appear on? Oh, it goes right at its position, Z mid. Okay, so it wouldn't work if I were to do it up at the high position because it's a Vec 2. Oh, well, we won't do any on the top. It's cool. It's enough on the bottom. Let's see if it's timed right, though. It needs to be right when it starts to open. He just yawned. Oh, she got a video of him yawning. I would love to see that. Oh, okay, so it needs to be right after that. Which means I should probably hook this up as another kind of anim. Do I want to? I don't really want to. I don't want to. Sweet, that was about the right time. And so you can go anime goal center 1.8, so maybe that's... This is actually supposed to be delay plus duration times a half. Nice, I like it. Just that little bit of dust was pretty cool. Okay, let's see this all in context. First, I'll check it in though. You gotta love the wizard dust, don't you? I love my wizard dust. I'm gonna call this commit wizard dust. Wizard dust. Commit number HAJ. Okay, so I'm gonna start in the room just below here so I can fight the boss. Actually, let's start from the room below that. Start from the before boss room. So I'm about finished with today's stream. I'm just gonna play this one last time and see how this looks all in context. So you fight the boss, then you go in the goal room and you have this sort of like moment like, whoa, sweet. I got another cool item. Already killed him. Damn it. Hey. Oh man, where's my Franker faces? I think it is. I gotta reinstall Franker faces. This is embarrassing. You don't have Franker faces installed. Cheating. Kick. Oh, I forgot I don't even have that heat armor. I'm just taking damage the whole time. Like, why is this guy so much harder than he usually is? So now the boss fight's over. Let's see how this looks. Yeah, that was cool. With the fade in too, with the teleporter fading in and all that. I love it. Yeah, it's so much better. Love it, I love it, I love it. Sweet. So that's it for today's stream. The spiders are green because the other guys, they were used to be orange and you couldn't tell them apart from the regular flames. They're lime flavored. I was getting my ass kicked. Well, I'll see you guys later. Have a great night. Thanks a lot for watching. Hope you all are having a great day and pleasant evening. Top of the evening to you.